Hello, welcome back to my channel, Charlie's Lessons, and in this video we're going to start with a little story. Recently at work we got some great news as we won a contract to teach an Indian company English online. And this process took just over a month from when they first contacted us to various meetings online, talking about what their objectives were, meeting with the company director, and also some of the prospective students. After these meetings, everything went really well and they were really happy with what we could offer. But just a few days before they accepted the contract, they had one condition. All the material had to be done on PowerPoint. Yes, Microsoft PowerPoint. So I sat down and thought, how am I gonna do these classes only with PowerPoint? Where, you know, I wanna do things like quizzes, I wanna play videos in the PowerPoint, I want it to be interactive. And when I was working on PowerPoint, I just didn't find any of these features. That's when I found out about Ispring Solutions. And Ispring Solutions is basically the equivalent of Pear Deck for Google Slides. So by the end of this video, even if you're not using PowerPoint, you're gonna want to use it just so you can use Ispring Solutions. So let's go take a look. The first thing you need to do is obviously have Microsoft PowerPoint on your computer. And the second thing is you're going to need to go to ispringsolutions.com and just download it for free. Then when you open PowerPoint, when you go to the menu at the top, on the right hand side, there should be a tab that says Ispring Suite. This presentation is for a young learner class, as you know, young learners love animals. So what I had were some slides that used the quiz. For example, we had the hotspot quiz type, then we had the sequence quiz type, and then a numeric quiz type. So let me just show you what that looks like. Now what you have to do is click on where you think the dog's nose is. So with these types of activities, what I would have maybe is I would let the students, if you're teaching online, I would let them remotely access the quiz. If not, I would ask them to tell me where it is by annotating the screen, and then I would choose myself as the teacher. So for example, where's the dog's nose? Let's see, I'm just gonna try it here. Let's submit. I got it right. Then we had an activity about which animals are largest or biggest. So let's see, let's pop a turtle here. I think that's good to go, let's see. Yes, and how many legs does a cat have? Let's see, 4. So what you saw there were just 3 of the many question types that Ispring Solutions does have with the quiz maker that you can use with your classrooms. The next section I want to show you are the interactive elements you can include in your PowerPoint presentation with Ispring Solutions. It's very simple. We just go to interaction. We've got all these different types of interactions, so processes, annotations, hierarchies, and catalogs. I'm going to show you a presentation I made for my Cambridge exam students using the annotation slide and also the glossary slide. We were looking at the part 2 of the Cambridge speaking exam, so when they have to describe the photos. And this was done as a revision activity for a class that we'd already done in person. So what I did was I went to the next slide and I used the hotspot feature. And the way this works, as you can see, I've got all these areas marked on the picture that include important or useful language they can use to describe those areas of the picture. So for example, if we start with this one here, what I was referring to was the weather, and I had here a phrase that they could use. Then I had about the background and so on. On the third slide, I had the glossary interactive element, and I put together some problematic vocabulary that we had from the previous class. And here it's really nicely organized in alphabetical order for the students. Now, before we go look at dialogue simulation, which for me is the best feature of this program, I want to do take a look at how you can record video and audio and have that inserted into your PowerPoint or Ispring Solution presentation. So let's say you do want to include a video for your students that accompanies the slide. So what we do is click on record video. Hello, look, there's 2 of me. And then I'm just going to press record. I'm going to start speaking. And when I finish speaking, when I've finished describing what's on the accompanying slide, I'm going to press stop. Now this video, although you can't see it right now, it is embedded into this slide. And I'll show you now. You can see here, this blank white space in the center of the screen is this slide. And on the top right hand right-hand side, you can see there's that video that I just recorded via iSpring, and I can just pop it in into the center or pop it back to the right. And if I just press play,
I'm gonna start speaking.
And this could be really useful for especially giving homework to your students. And I'm gonna show you soon how we can export these presentations and send them to your students. So if you would like to give your students that feeling of a flipped classroom or a blended classroom, then you can send video recordings of yourself giving instruction to your students using this feature. And the same goes for screen recording. So once again, the idea of giving your students these presentations when they're at home makes screen recording an excellent addition to your presentation. So what we do is we click on new recording. Immediately it gives us the canvas or the area in which it's going to record, and all we have to do is press record, and it will record everything we do on the screen, and that will then be added to accompany the slide that you are using. I'm going to show you how to make a dialogue simulation on Ispring Solutions. All you do is first click on dialogue simulation, and this is going to open up Ispring Talk Master. Once this is started, all you're going to do is create your new scene, which I've done already here. We need to add a character and a background. So let's go to character. I want to go kind of informal, so let's go to this guy here. Then we're going to choose, you know, happy, normal, puzzled, unhappy, or angry. Oh my God, look how angry he looks. And let's put him in dentist chair. Have him ask a question. Are you going to take out all my teeth? And then reply, we're going to add. Now I'm going to make this second option the correct option, let's say. So what I'll do is I'll click on this drag to link, and this will link to another scene. Now the way this works is this is going to be now the next step in the simulation, or the next step in the conversation. This is one I made earlier, and it has 7 separate scenes. So I'm going to go to my presentation, which was giving advice in English. Here is our good friend who's working on a construction site, and he's asking us, hey man, how's it going? So I click on this one. Oh, I'm not doing great. I really hate my job. What happened? Do you want to quit? Oh, now look at him now. He looks even unhappier. We've got to really help him here. I want to look for a new job. Any ideas? You should leave if you're unhappy. What would you like to do? Oh, that's a nice question. I'd love to be a teacher. An English teacher. Well, what do you know? I love working with children too. Okay, well, be careful with that. Sounds like a great idea. Oh, he's looking puzzled again. He's got another question. I'd love to do a course. Which one should I do? Let's do the first one. Oh my God, look how happy he is now. No worries. My pleasure. I ended the slideshow with this interactive element about giving advice in English. If you're working or creating your Ispring Solutions presentation at home and not at work, and you want to take it into work to use it in your classroom, or you want to send it to your students to study at home, then you're going to need to take a look at how you export the presentation, which is what we're going to look at now. So this is my giving advice in English presentation. I would just go to publish. I'm going to choose the my computer option, so publishing it as a file, and I'm going to publish it as HTML5. Once we've published the presentation, it will appear in a folder just like this, and this index file will launch the presentation, and voila, here we have the presentation. If you'd like to send it in a format that's even easier to use than that, all you need to do is go to the Ispring website and look for this article on how to convert a published presentation into an executable file. You download this file here. So we just take the folder and we just pop it into this. Go to run. You can send this file now to your students. So if the students open this, then it's going to directly open up the presentation on their computer. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial on using Ispring Solutions with PowerPoint. If you do use PowerPoint, then I highly recommend getting the free trial of Ispring Solutions onto your computer now. And even if you don't use PowerPoint usually, well, go check it out anyway, because Ispring Solutions can be a great addition to your classroom.